will take your breath away. Like you're rocking on top of that Ferris wheel at the county fair. And I know it's so cliche, but she's as good as gold.
This is my channel. Yeah, for today's look, I decided to do a little something different. I think I'm gonna call this video,
but nothing compares.
She's the kind you give your sunset ombre smoky eye. Yeah, I actually really like this look, and I decided to add a wing liner because who doesn't love a wing liner sharp enough to cut a bitch? Yeah, I actually really like this look. It's just kind of like my basic nude lip that I always do. But I've done this combo a few times on my channel, but I've just been loving it recently, and it's just like, it's not too dark, not too nude, it's perfect. I love it. It's amazing. Yeah, and I think it pairs really good with this eye color, because this eye that I did, it has a lot of warmer undertones. So I love it, and I did a different highlight today. I did more of like a golden highlight, because we applied some gold and copper on the lid. I wanted to kind of like complement the cheek area with that. Yeah, I had a lot of fun doing this tutorial. When I do this eye makeup look, a lot of people do like it, because I don't know, I think when I do a liner, a lot of people like it. Like, my boyfriend loves it, because it's like, kind of sexy Asian kind, but I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing. Yeah, but it took me a little longer to do the liner today, because I haven't done a wing liner in a really long time, and I'm not the best at it. But like, some of my friends or coworkers, they're like, you're so good at wing liner, what are you talking about? But I'm such a perfectionist. It's just like, this part, I kind of put too thick here, like it looks okay, but I don't know, and I kind of fucked up here a little bit, you guys can't notice it, but yeah, so, yeah, but it looks good. I'm not really going anywhere, so it's not like it has to be perfect, but I'm such a perfectionist, but I love it with this lash. Yeah, I just love this lip, because it's really different than what I usually do. It's not super, super smoky, but it's smoky enough. And I love stepping outside of the box that you guys are doing different looks here on my channel. Anyways, you guys, for tomorrow's look, I was thinking of doing, like, I'm gonna call it another easy glam tutorial, makeup tutorial. So I wanted to do pretty, like, a simple kind of smoky eye, like a really subtle one, but I wanted to add glitter on the lower lash line. I have done it on my channel before, but I used silver, but I want to do gold with a red lip. And I mentioned to you guys, I haven't used this lip color in a tutorial yet. I've used tons of all my, basically all my favorite reds on my channel so far. But I haven't used this one, which I love. Excuse me, I have a hiccup. But I haven't used this one. And this lip color is, I actually found this lip color on 50 Shades of Grey. Anastasia, whatever her freaking name is. That's lucky to have sex with Christian Grey, but she wore this lip color, and it looks so beautiful on screen. As soon as I got home from the theater, I literally like typed it in, Anastasia Steel lip color in 50 Shades, and this is what popped up. And her lips look so beautiful, especially because Dakota Johnson, she has a really nice complexion. Like, she has a very creamy complexion, and I love her skin. I love her. She's just so beautiful. And then she wore this, and I thought it looked like literally like velvet, like red velvet on her lips. So I bought it. This is one of my favorite red. It's called Feel So Grand. So I'm super excited to show you guys that tomorrow, because I haven't used this on my channel. I've used tons of other lip colors in this formula, and I love it. You guys know this is like my favorite, one of my favorite lip colors. I definitely think not a lot of people know about it. It's definitely underrated. I don't know why more people don't talk about it, but I love it, and I definitely recommend it, and it's just amazing. Yeah, so I'm super excited for that tomorrow. But yeah, if you guys want to see how I achieved this look or created this look, feel free to keep on watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel so you guys know about all the updates here on my channel. And yeah, if you guys recreate this look, just tag me. I love it when you guys tag me and let me know. And I love it when you guys compliment me, and I always compliment you guys back. And if you guys have a makeup channel on here, I will, and like, message me or like even comment below, just say please follow me. I'll for sure follow you, and I always follow all the people that follow me. So yeah, just send me a message. I always try to message you guys back because I like interacting with you guys because we're a community here. So just let me know. Subscribe, and I'll subscribe back at you because we got each other's back. I love you guys so much. I'll see you tomorrow. Bye.
Hey, y'all. Welcome back to my channel.
Yeah. So, what's up, guys? What's new? Yeah, I'm going to do a Sunset Ombre Smokey Eye today. So, I'm super excited about that. Yesterday, I took a day off. I was so tired, and I decided to do my nails instead. They're actually glowing. Yeah, so we're going to get started. It's going to be, like, a pretty, like, basic smoky eye, but not too basic. But then it's smoky enough, and then we'll have some nude lips. Yeah, it's like weird because last time I did like a dark lip or a bold lip, a red lip. I'm just using this Kopari lip glossy. I love this stuff. They do have one in like a nude shimmer, but I just love the clear one just for hydrating purposes. I'm just applying this all over my lips because my lips are still motherfucking dry because of the weather. And it hasn't been as hot and as sunny in Vancouver lately, which I'm loving. And I think, like, when the weather changes, my lips are just dry. Okay, now we're just going to, like, because I put foundation, concealer, under eye powder, face powder, and eyebrows. I just want to basically melt all that stuff I put on my face into my skin. So I'm just using the Morphe Continuous Setting Mist. I love this stuff because it's like, it doesn't like ruin your makeup, and you have like an actual spray. It like squirts in your face, and it just kind of gives you a soft mist. Also, I like doing this for hydration purposes. I kind of put too much here, but whatever. Okay, we're gonna go in with the Morphe times Jaclyn Hill palette. You guys know this is like my go-to palette for all my looks here on my channel. And I'm gonna go in with Silk Cream. I know, she hit pan, y'all. She is very loved. Okay, I'm just gonna use this Morphe R37. This is always the first brush I use to apply in my crease. So I just dip the tip in there. Oops. And just swirled around. Swirl, 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 and just tap the excess off. And we're just gonna basically apply all in the crease here. Yeah, yesterday I did so much. Did my nails, I made some quesadillas, went grocery shopping. I was really tired after. Yeah, so then I just, like, decided not to film yesterday. I was like, oh my god, it's already 7 o'clock. Screw it. I'll film the next day. And I did my exercises. I haven't really been doing my exercises. I'm feeling, like, a little bit tired. And I think I need to start doing that, like, not exercising. Like, usually I go to the gym 5 to 6 days a week. So when you don't and all of a sudden you stop, your body crashes, basically. Okay. Just apply this all in the crease area. Just like that. Like that. Ta-da! Okay, now we're going to put some under eye powder. I'm just going to use the Fenty Beauty Pro Filt'r powder in the shade Lavender. I only have a little bit left, so that's why I'm not dumping it out, basically. I'm just going to use what I have left. So we're going to do some kind of like darker purples, and I don't want fallout. You know me. I'm gonna go in with, I have more powder in there. I'm gonna go in with the Fenty Pro Filt'r Instant Retouch Setting Powder in the shade Butter. I actually haven't used this one. Like, I bought the Lavender, I loved it, but I got a sample of this one. I prefer this one more for some reason, because I feel like the, the Lavender one. Oops. So it's like kind of like a soft yellow. Like, I don't know if you guys know the Ben Nye banana powder. That's more yellow. This is like a very, like, it's a softer yellow. So I'm just going to dip, because that's on this eye. It's not enough for me. I don't want, this one doesn't smell as strong as the other one, which is weird, as the Lavender one. I believe Nikki Tutorials uses the Butter one, which is weird because she's a lot more pale than me. So you would think she would use the Lavender, but she says she likes this one better, which... I can't blame her. And usually when I empty a jar like this, I'll clean it, I'll wash it, and I'll use it for, like, something else. Like, I'll put, like, gemstones, or I'll just keep it just in case, because you never know. You could, like, use it in the future. I'm just going to put that on the side. Okay, now we're going to go back in with that R37 brush, and I'm just going to grab that Silk Cream again, and I just want to extend it a little bit, because we applied that under eye powder underneath. You just want to... So we don't do this step, it'll kind of like cut off, and it won't be like as cat eye as I want. Especially like with this eye look, I want it that cat eye look, you know? Just like this, really softly. I'm going to add another transition shade, so go. Okay, I'm going to use the Morphe M441. This is a little bit more denser than the first one. This one's a little more fluffy, and I want to apply, like, some darker crease areas just to make that eye color more pigmented. So I'm going to go in with this one. This is MFEO. It's a little bit more of a peachy transition shade. I just want to deepen that transition shade just a little bit. You know, okay, we're just gonna like place this all over, just below that Silk Cream color, and kind of extend it a little bit. I love this brush. It's so soft. Anything with just like the black handle and just the silver writing, they're actually really soft, I have to say. Now we're going to have some fun. We're going to add glitter now. Yeah. Okay, I'm going to use the MAC 242 brush. This is my favorite brush for applying any glitter or shimmer onto the lid. And I think I'm going to go in with Queen. I would like something a little like not as gold, but... I want to be gold, and this color, like, is such a beautiful gold, to be honest. We're just going to spray a brush with some setting spray. Always do this with any glitter or shimmer I apply on my lid, just because I love how it looks. It just makes it so metallic looking. So we're just going to pop it right in the inner corner here, not the whole lid, because this is Ombre Smokey Eye. Like that. Yeah, that's actually really pretty. What am I thinking? Too gold? Who am I? Okay, I'm just going to apply. I really like to apply shimmers like in two layers because I find it just shows up a lot more pigmented. So just in the inner corner, like kind of like half, like where your arch is right there. That's a precise analogy, if you would say. Or not. Same with nail polish. Like, you do it in layers. You put a base, you put two coats, depending the color, how opaque it is. Okay. Okay, now I'm just gonna grab this coppery shade. This is called Firework. This is actually a really pretty color. I have used it on my channel before. Guys, no, it's like my go-to copper color. We're just gonna use the clean side of the MAC 242 brush. And then we're just gonna dip in that copper shade Firework and just spray. And we're just gonna layer on top of that gold color. Just right in the center. And I always spray the setting spray twice just to make sure. You want that setting spray to make, you want it to be pigmented, or like not soaking but down. So it applies the shimmer like really nicely. I'm gonna put too much, but whatever. Okay, now I'm just gonna grab the Morphe M433. This is definitely my favorite shading brush for just deepening that color in the outer corner. Okay, we're gonna use a different palette. I'm gonna use the Morphe times the Jaclyn Hill palette. This is the Bling Boss palette. This is one of my go-to purpley palettes. It just has so many amazing colors and I love it. So I'm gonna go in with the shade Rockstar. This is one of my favorite shades of all time. I love it. I use it so many times on my channel. I'm just gonna tap really lightly because this purple is quite pigmented, which is crazy because purples are like the hardest to develop, just saying. Then we're just gonna tap this in the outer corner. Just really lightly, because these Morphe shadows are very pigmented. Just really lightly. And just go a little at a time. That's what I always do. It's better to go a little at a time than like go overboard and then you're spending like half an hour blending it out and then your eyelid hurts so bad because you're blending so much. So just tap right in the outer corner. I was gonna go in with a darker color, but this actually complements the gold and the copper really nicely. So this is what I'm doing. And just in that outer corner. Like that. Yeah, that actually looks really pretty. I'm with it. Okay, we're gonna do the other eye. And just kind of like extend it out a little bit. Okay, and then I'm going to grab that M441 because I just want to basically blend that purple out. And I'm going to go in with the shade Pukey. So this is a good color to blend out that in-between transition color. Just right over top of that. Okay, that seems good. Now we're just gonna basically go back in with all those colors. So we're gonna, because when I blended that out, kind of all those colors faded. So we're gonna go back in with Queen, that gold color. I know it's a high maintenance eye look, but I always do this. And it's not Angelique tutorial if it's not high maintenance, because I'm a high maintenance biatch. Okay, just gonna tap that in the inner corner. Like that, yeah. See, that's so much more intense. Because this definitely like faded, and I don't want a faded eye look. I want an intense eye look. I want to be popping. I think I'm going to do a wing liner today. I think it'll look really pretty. I look. And I don't do a lot of wing liners on my channel. I don't know why. I just don't. Okay, now we're going to go in with Firework again, just to put it in the center. Basically, we're just redoing what we did, just to deepen it a little bit. And because we already put that color, we just have to go over it once. So I don't want it too overpowering. Yeah, that's better. Okay, and then we're going to go in with that Bling Boss palette in the shade Rockstar. I honestly, this is like my favorite shade. Such a pretty, like, magenta purple. We're just going to tap that in the outer corner. Really lightly. Just a little at a time, you guys. And then we're gonna do the other eye, lashes. I think I'm gonna go in with eyeliner first. I'm gonna use, this is the MAC Cosmetics Pro Longwear Fluidline. I love this. It's in the shade Blacktrack. I love this eyeliner. And then I'm just gonna use the Morphe M443. We're just gonna place this in our waterline really quickly. My eyes are a little bit sensitive, but that's okay. I'm going for a little bit of a smoky look, so I want to apply eyeliner first, and then when we apply the darker purple, it's just going to smoke out that liner, because I was thinking of doing like a nude or a white liner, but I want this look to be smoky. 4, 2, 3. I love this brush for applying any dark shadow under my lash. So we're just going to go in with that Morphe Bling Boss palette that Jaclyn Hill collaborated with Morphe. And then we're just going to go in with Rockstar, that kind of magenta purpley color. Such a pretty color. I'm just going to tap the excess off. I'm just going to put this below the lashes. That, I know I look freaking crazy, but it's gonna come together. Okay, that looking creepy, but it's gonna come together. I'm gonna use the Morphe R41. It's this really pretty pencil brush. This is from their Rose Gold collection. I love this brush. We're gonna do something different. So we're gonna use Firework just to blend out that purple. I've been using like a shimmer or kind of a glittery kind of color to blend out darker matte colors, and I've been loving it recently. I don't know, I'm just into it. lips, which you wouldn't think, like, you would do that, but it actually looks really good. You guys should try it. I'm just going to blend that rock star color out with that copper shade. This copper shade looks really pretty with this purple. I don't know, it blends well together because I think they have like a really warm undertone. So okay, I just want that a little more smoky, so we're just going to use this Kylie brush and this Firework color. And then we're just going to blend that out. Sorry, my mom's texting me. That's why, like, when I look like this, I'm reading a text, but I'll message her after. I'm just going to blend that out. Yeah, that looks way better just because it's, like, with every smoky look, I just love a blend out look. I don't know. It's my vibe. Now, I'm just gonna conceal my eyebrows really quickly. I know a lot of people don't do this, so I don't have the need to, like, explain that I do this. But I do it just because it, like, makes the eyeshadow look really perfect. I'm just using the Tarte Shape Tape like I was using earlier on my face. And I'm using this definer dye. This is the Morphe 432. I love this brush. I use it for, like, everything. I love this powder. It's so beautiful. And I'm just going to use this smudger guide. This is the Morphe M213. I think I'm just going to use this. I'm just going to use in light and beam for my inner corner. And then I'm going to use the Morphe M455. And I'm just going to spray my brush and lightly put this in my inner corner. Yeah, because I want more of a lighter highlight today, not as gold, I guess. Anything else? I'm just going to use this Jaclyn Hill times Morphe palette in the shade Arm and Gorgeous. I'm going to use that VIP color. I love this VIP color because it's like so white looking. I love it. I'm into it. Yeah, that's the fit most of that part. Okay, now I'm going to do under eye powder. So I'm going to use the MAC Cosmetics. This is the shaping powder in the shade Emphasis. I just want to use this today. I'm just going to use my sponge. I know, I need more. I hit pan, but there's still some in there. And I'm just going to place this under the eye. I love this powder for under the eye. It's so beautiful. Especially because I'm so pale, like paper, basically. This is like the perfect color. I want to try the, I think it's like a beigey powder with like light shimmer, like similar to this. It's called Light Sweet, but I don't know. I just love the Emphasis one so much. Okay, now that's done. Put that away. We're going to need that later, but right now, I'm going to do eyeliner now. Where's my... I need to find my eyeliner brush. Here you are. Here you are. So I'm going to use this Royal Lamb Nickel. This is actually a brow brush, but I use it as eyeliner because it's my bitch. And we're just going to go back in with that MAC Cosmetics Pro Longwear Fluidline Eyeliner in the shade Blacktrack. And we're just going to do the wing. But I gotta move my mirror because I want you guys to see. Hopefully I didn't drink too much coffee, so I'm not shaking. I'm gonna do the right eye first because I always do that eye. So we're just gonna dip in that MAC liner. And I always like do a swipe on my hand to make sure it's not like clumpy. And then we're just gonna pull the skin. I feel like I can't see. Okay. Do like a line like that and then go back. Sorry guys, my eyes is watering a little bit. And then I'll go in the inner corner and kind of like trace it. Like that, that looks good. This eye is a little bit watery, so I'm just like being really, really careful, kind of going back and forth. So, okay, moving on to lashes, we're going to go in with the Flutter Double Lift Lashes in the shade, and not the shade, the Style Intoxicating Shade, yeah. Okay, I just want to see how this looks with these intoxicating lashes, because I did like kind of extend it, but whatever. Yeah, that's actually really pretty. It's like smokiness, you know? Just like that, yeah. Ta-da! Okay, let that dry. We're gonna do the other one. That looks pretty. I feel like with liner, I look more Asian because it kind of gives you that cat eye look. Okay, we're just gonna apply this on the other eye. Only my eye doesn't want it. I didn't do a super thick line because I wanted you to see that kind of ombre on the lid. So usually I do like a thicker liner. This is a sculpting powder from MAC. This is in the shade of Shadestar. I love this color. I just want to use this for today. And then I'm going to go in. This is the Morphe R10 from their Rose Gold collection. We're just going to dip in that Shadestar color. Just going to put these away really quickly. Yeah, it's looking cute. I've been doing a liner in like a while. I don't know. I feel like I look different. Just tap the excess off and we're just going to... Okay, I'm gonna use, bronzer. I think I wanna use a different bronzer for today's look. I'm gonna use this one. This is the Too Faced Chocolate Soleil bronzer. I love this bronzer, and it's not too dark. It's like the perfect neutral undertone, especially because I'm so pale. And it smells like chocolate. I love it. I'm not fresh to use. I think I'm gonna use this one. This is the Morphe R2 from the Rose Gold collection. I've been loving this brush lately. And we're just gonna lightly bronze the cheeks. Oh my god, this bronzer smells so good. The color is just so pretty. And whenever I have liner, I'm really careful, like, when applying bronzer, because you'll just, like, take it off, kind of, but you shouldn't. Yeah, it's a really pretty color. I don't know why I don't use this bronzer more often. It smells so good. Okay, now we're just gonna bake the face. We're gonna use the translucent loose setting powder from Laura Mercier. Just gonna quickly bake the bottom half of the cheeks. Thank you. Okay, now, I just, like, lost my train of thought. I'm just gonna quickly contour the nose with that Chocolate Soleil bronzer. I'm just gonna use this Kylie Slanted Goat Hair Brush. And this is a really pretty bronzer, so it's a good, nose contour shape. It's a little harsh, but whatever. Okay, now we're going to go back in with that shaping powder from MAC in the shade Emphasis, just using the sponge. I'm just going to tap really lightly on the middle of the nose, upper lip, and forehead. And then we're going to take the baby off. Such a beautiful, like, face powder. I love it. Okay, now we're going to take the baby off. Goodbye. This is just how I've been doing my makeup lately. I just love the result of it. Just leaving that powder on for, like, just a few minutes instead of, like, an hour. It's just perfect. Okay, we're gonna put that away. I just wanna double check if, like, everything's looking right. Yeah, I always go back and forth just to make sure my makeup actually does look good. She looks good. She does. Okay, and now I think I'm gonna go in with blush. I'm gonna use a MAC blush. I used a lot of MAC products today. I'm gonna go in with the shade Melba. This is their powder blush. This is my favorite. This is my favorite blush. I'm just gonna use, oh my god, I have to sneeze, but this is, oh my god, woo! I'm gonna use the shade, I'm gonna use Morphe Y4 brush, and I'm just using the shade Melba in MAC powder blush. I love this blush. I just want a really light, rosy kind of, this is kind of like a coral peachy shade, and it's so pretty. It's like my favorite blush. I love mixing it with a lot of different blushes too. Like, MAC Copper Tone or MAC Modern Mandarin with Melba. It's so beautiful. But on its own, it's really pretty. This is a really good blush, like, if you're really fair or for your wedding day. It's just so pretty. Gives you, like, a very natural flush look. Because on your wedding day, you don't want to look too flush for really fair girls. Which, I'm fair. Let me tell you. And I always like to smile. You just want the apples of the cheeks. Perfect. Perfect. Okay. I think that's enough. I don't want to be too blushing. And then I'm going to go in with the Hourglass Ambient Lighting Powder in the shade Luminous Light. I love using this powder after I apply my bronzer, my blush. It just adds an extra glow. So you want to be really, like, naturally glowing. Enough. I don't want to be too glowy. And then I'm just going to use some of that Morphe Continuous Setting Mist just to, before we apply actual highlight, I just want to be extra glowy. Okay. but don't open your eyes too quickly because we have eyeliner. I want to use a different highlight today. I mentioned in my last video, this one, this is the Becca Shimmering Skin Perfector Press Highlighter in Gold Lava. I believe this was special edition, but if they don't have it on Sephora on their website, check Beautylish. So usually they have special editions, but I just want to, because we did kind of gold coppery look, I just want to use this on the skin, and it's so different. It's definitely more subtle than the Fenty Trophy Wife one, but this one, yeah, it's not as gold, but I do love that one. So I'm just using the Morphe times Jeffree Star JS4. Okay, I'm just gonna tap this onto the cheeks. I haven't used this one in a long time, so I'm kind of in it. Just really lightly, you don't want too much, you know? My hair is like everywhere. It's pretty. Okay, and then I'm just gonna use the beauty sponge. I'm just gonna tap into this one and onto the skin, because I just love applying highlight with this sponge. It just like makes it really seamless looking. Yeah, I'm all about the seamless highlight. Now I'm gonna go in with Champagne Pop, because I love to be champagne popping. I feel like this is a little too gold. So I think I want to add some Champagne Pop, just because Champagne Pop has really nice peachy undertones, and it's going to balance this out a little bit. And let's be real, I love to be champagne popping. I can't help it, I just love this highlight so much. Yeah, that looks better. It's not as gold. I'm a double D, so, which is crazy. Honestly, I'm so envious of girls. Like, they can just walk out the house because they have small boobs. They don't have to wear a bra. So jealous. But then they're like jealous I have big boobs, which I hate them, to be honest. And the only person that likes them is my man. Okay. I don't know what lip combination I want to use. I think I'm just going to use the one I've been using lately. So I'm going to go in with the Morphe color pencil in the shade Sweet Tea. I love this color because it's a really pretty neutral brown. This is actually one of their top favorites, I believe. Like, I believe a lot of Hispanic people like this shade because it blends in with their skin tone really well. But I'm just going to apply this everywhere. I'm just going to blend it out with my finger. Just to make it not as dark. If you guys feel like a lip liner or a lipstick's too dark, just use your finger to blend it out. Just blend it in the lip line, not outside it, or you'll kind of ruin what you have. What lip color do I want to use? I'm just going to use this one because I've been loving this lipstick. This is the Maybelline New York. What is this? I think this is their Color Sensational lipstick. It's a shine lipstick. I'll swatch it for you guys. But it's a really pretty nude and I love it. This will nude out the lip liner we applied. So pretty. I love it. And then lip gloss. I used this combo before, but I've just been loving it recently because it's nude, but not too nude. I'm going to use the Becca Cosmetics times Chrissy Teigen Glow Gloss. I believe this is in Beach Bum. It doesn't say, but I know it is. Trust me. Such a pretty gloss. Okay, and then I'm just going to use some Morphe Continuous Setting Mist again, just to seal the deal. Okay, and then now I'm going to use some brow gel. I'm using the Anastasia Clear Brow Gel. It's my favorite. Just good. And then I'm just going to use the Lower Lash Mascara. I'm going to go in with the MAC Extended Play Giga Black Lash. I love this mascara because of the wand for lower lashes. Actually, it looks really good. I don't know, it's just different than what I usually do. Okay, I'm just going to curl my hair real quickly. I'll be right back, you guys.
So, you guys, that's it for this video, if that makes you happy. Yeah, I actually really like how this look turned out. I just wanted to do something really different here on my channel, just because I haven't done this look before. Like, I think I did a little bit of an ombre one with, I think it was called my aqua blue, gold glitter, and purple smoky eye. But this is just, I don't know, it's different. The colors are very similar to each other, so they kind of mesh well together and blend well together. And I just wanted to do a wing liner for you guys. I mean, it's not perfect, but who cares? You guys get the gist. I mean, you know, it's just... I'm not very good at wing liner, to be honest, because I don't wear it every day on a daily basis. But when I do like it. But yeah, I think this look looks really pretty with a wing liner. And I look like more Asian, because it looks like I have this really extended cat eye. I don't know. I'm kind of into it. I'm with it. Yeah, so I hope you guys like this tutorial. Oh my god, my hair is so crazy. I did wash it yesterday, but yeah. Anyways, you guys, I had so much fun filming this video. Yeah, for tomorrow's look, I told you guys I was going to do like another, I'm going to call it another easy glam tutorial, but I'm going to do more of a simple eye, and I wanted to add a gold glitter underneath. I've done that look with silver glitter, but I want to do it with gold glitter, and then I wanted to use a red lip, and I was thinking of using this, I was going to say Makeup Forever, this MAC Cosmetics Retro Liquid Lip and Feel So Grand. I've used this formula tons of times on my channel. I used the darker brown, and you guys love that one on me because it's really, really dark brown. And I did use the Dose of Colors one, but I love this formula, especially because for a darker bold lip or a red bold lip, I don't like to put a gloss on because I find if you put too much, it kind of like doesn't look as good throughout the day as a nude. But I mean, you could do that, but I don't really like to apply gloss for bold colors. That's just how I feel. That's like my own thing. But I love this formula, and I have used the nude ones on my channel before. And my two favorite nudes is Burnt Spice and Lady Be Good. These are like the perfect nude. The formula is amazing. I love it. It lasts all day long. Like, even if you put it on the back of your hand, you literally have to use like makeup wipe with eye makeup remover because it bitch is on there. But it's an amazing formula. I love it. It's like one of my go-tos. Oh, this thing.
It's one of like my go-to's liquid lip. They're amazing. So I wanted to do that for tomorrow's look. Yeah, red lip. And I've been getting amazing feedback from you guys lately, you doing more of a red lip. I don't usually wear red lips on a daily basis, but I love doing it for you guys on my channel. And I'm definitely getting more confident wearing them, because you definitely got to have a bold personality. You got to have confidence if you do want to do a red lip. And I'm kind of getting there, if you know what I mean. But my go-to nude lip is always this one. I've done this nude lip before, but I just been loving it, so I did it for today's video. Anyways, you guys, that's enough chit-chatting. Babbling, it's really hot in here, and I feel a little tired. And I still gotta mop the floor. Nothing compared. Yeah, but anyways, you guys, I'm gonna go. I'm gonna edit this video as soon as I can. I'm really hungry. I'm gonna eat something, mop the floor, and basically do what I do. Anyways, you guys, I love you so much. I can't wait to do the one for you guys. And don't forget to subscribe. Just a pretty face. She's a different kind of hot. Can make any heart melt with just one smile. Her laugh will warm you up like Kentucky bourbon in a country sign, like a little smoke hitting your lungs. Just her love and nothing compares. She's the kind you'll give your life for, the kind you'll thank your God for, the kind you'll drive 24 minutes out of your way just to make a day. She's the kind that meets your family, the one that changes everything. The kind that's got a lot more than just a pretty face. She's a different kind of hot, hot, hot. It's a different kind of hot, 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 whoa, whoa. She's the kind you'll give your life for, the kind you'll thank your God for, the kind you'll drive 24 minutes out of your way just to make a day. She's the kind that meets your family, the one that changes everything. The kind that's got a lot more than just a pretty face. She's a different.